Hello, today we will be making this video in Cinema 4D. So let's start. Firstly, insert a cube, click here, and then resize this. Change this value to 60, Y value to 20, and Z value to 300. And then change segments, keep X as 1, Y make it 3, and Z make it 6. Come over here, click on display, and click on Garage Shading Lines. Now zoom in. Make this cube editable by clicking on this button here. Then click on Polygons. And select this surface and this surface. Use shift key to select both the surface at the same time. Then right click and click extrude. Then click and hold your left mouse button and drag your mouse towards the right like this. Okay, and extrude offset value to 30. Perfect. This looks good. Now zoom out. Next, go over here and insert a rectangle like this. Zoom out further and change the value of this rectangle. Come over here and change the width to 3000. Enter. And then click on this rounding and increase the radius value to 200 like this. Next, go to Move Graph here and insert a cloner. Then make this cube the child of this cloner like this. Then click on this cloner and come over here and change this mode from linear to object. And drag this rectangle and drop on this object like this. Perfect. Now come to transform and change this p value to 90 degree. Type it 90 like this. And b value to minus 90 like this. Then come to object and distribution count, change it to even, and then increase this count to 85. Perfect. This is how it looks like now. Lastly, come to this rate and change this value to 5% like this. Now let's play our animation. So click on this play button here. Perfect. So this is how the animation is now working. Now stop the animation, go back to frame 0 and increase the frame value to 220 and then drag this and expand this. Next, click E on your keyboard, come over here and insert a tube, this one. Now change the orientation to minus Z and then increase the height over here, make it 300, and then outer radius make it 185 centimeter, keep inner radius as 50 centimeter, and cap segment make it 3, and rotation segment make it 20. Now go to this coordinate and change this X value to minus 1300. Now come over here. Next, make this tube editable by clicking on this button. Then click on this polygons and select this polygon. And then click shift key on your keyboard and start selecting alternate polygons like this. Okay, and then click delete on your keyboard. Now we will go to the other side, rotate, and click on this polygon and delete. Let's see if this is the right one. No, this is not the right one. So Control Z, click on this and then delete. And then start selecting alternate polygons like this. Use shift key on your keyboard. Perfect. And now click delete. Okay, so this looks good. We will rotate back. Okay, so now let's animate this tube. So click on this tube over here and make sure that you are on frame 0. And on frame 0, drop this keyframe over here on rotation B. Click this. Now move your pointer to frame number 220, last frame, like this. and change this value to -792, and then drop a keyframe. Click this. Perfect. Now go back to frame 0 and let's play our animation. Okay, so this is moving both the conveyor belt and the front wheel. Now stop, go back to frame 0, come over here, right click, click on animation, and then click on show F curve. Now click somewhere in between, then on your keyboard click Ctrl plus A and then click on this linear button and then close it. Now come over here, zoom out. Okay, perfect. Let's play our animation one more time. This looks good. Stop the animation, go back to frame 0. Now come over here on this tube and rename it front wheel. Now click on this and click Ctrl plus C to copy it and then Ctrl plus V to paste it. Now rename this second one and name it back wheel. Now click on this back wheel, come to this PX and change it to plus 1300. So here we are, we now have two wheels, this is front and this is back. Now let's play our animation one more time and this looks good. So stop the animation, go back to frame 0. Now let's make a bowl. So come over here and click on this sphere and then come to this object and change the radius value to 150 cm and change type to hemisphere like this. Now go to coordinates and change this value, rotation P value to 180 degrees like this. Now move this up, rotate and zoom. Now go back to this object and change this segment's value to 40. Next, come over here and make this bowl editable. Click on this button, then click on polygons, zoom in and click on one of this surface like this. Then on your keyboard click Ctrl plus A. This will select all the polygons. Now right click and click on extrude, this one. Next, come over here and click on this create caps and then click and hold left mouse button and drag your mouse towards the right and change this offset value to 15 cm. Okay, now click E on your keyboard, click on this edges over here and then go to select and select loop selection. Now come closer to over here and select this outer circle. Next, click shift on your keyboard and select this inner circle. Now zoom in and then right click and select this bevel. Come over here, click on this edge and drag it towards the left like this. Now come to this offset and change the value to 7 and also subdivision 7. Okay, so this is how it looks like now. Now zoom out like this. Click on this sphere, name it to bowl. Click on this and then click E on your keyboard and move it upward like this. Next, zoom in like this, rotate, perfect. Further, okay, good. Now click on this polygons here. Now go to select and click loop selection and then come over here and select this loop 1, 2, 3 and 4 and then click T on your keyboard and move this up like this and make sure that make it Y value as 0 and apply. Okay, so this looks good now. Now zoom out like this, move it like this, rotate. Okay, perfect. Now click on this over here. Next, click on this bowl and come to coordinates and change X value to 1100 and Y value to 362. Perfect. So this is placed over here. Now click somewhere in between and click Ctrl plus A on your keyboard and then move everything upward like this make sure that your y value is 391. Now click somewhere in between. Okay, perfect. So this looks good now. Next, we will go to simulate. Click here, click to particles and click emitter. Now click on emitter, go to coordinates and change x value to 1250 and y value to 1100 and keep z value as 0. This is our emitter. Now come to this rotation P and make it minus 90 like this. So this is our emitter now. Then go to this emitter and change this emitter type to cone. Next, come over here and insert a sphere like this and change the radius value to 30. And then come over here, drag this sphere and make it a child of this emitter. Now click on this emitter, go to particles and change birth rate value to 5. Okay, and on this stop emission, make it 170, make seed value as 1 and speed as 1000. And then click on show object like this. Now click on this sphere here, then right click, go to simulation tag and make it a rigid body. Next, come over here and scroll down and make bounce value to 0 and friction value to 200%. Enter. Now come to this cloner, click on this, right click, simulation tag and make it a collider body. Now click on this bowl, right click, simulation tag and make it a rigid body. Come over here and change this shape value to moving mesh like this and scroll down and make bounce as 0% and friction as 200%. Perfect, this looks good. Now let's play our animation one time. So click on this play button. Okay, so this is how it looks like. So stop the animation, go back to frame 0. Next, go over here and click on this cylinder. Now change the radius value to 75 and height to 300 cm. Enter. Rotation segment, make it 40 and then go to coordinates and change this x value to 1250 and y value to 1000. Okay, so here is our cylinder now. Next, rotate it like this, come closer like this. Okay, perfect. Now make this cylinder editable, click on this editable button, then click on this polygons and then select live selection and select all this like this and then click delete. Perfect. Now zoom out, rotate, click E on your keyboard. Next, right click on this cylinder, go to simulation tag and make it a collider body. Okay, now we will animate our cylinder and emitter both. So click on cylinder first, make sure that you are on frame 0 and on frame 0, drop a keyframe, click here and then go to frame number 180 like this. Okay, and then change this x value to minus 850. Enter and drop a keyframe again. Now right click over here, go to animation, go to show F curve, click somewhere in between, click Ctrl plus A and then click this linear button and close this. Now again go back to frame number 0 here, click on this emitter, drop a keyframe on frame 0, click this, then go to frame number 180 over here and change this x value to minus 850 and again drop a keyframe. Then right click over here, go to animation, show F curve, click somewhere in between, click Ctrl plus A and click linear and then close it. Now go back to frame 0, click this button and then insert a floor. So click here and floor, then go to display and select Gorad shadings and rotate a bit like this and let's play our animation. Go back to frame 0 and play. Okay, perfect. So this is how it looks like now. Let's stop the animation, go back to frame 0. Next, we will create materials for our objects. So come over here on this material manager, double click double click on this newly created material and then go to color and select a blue color like this, this. Change this H value to 190, S value to 90 and V value also to 90. Perfect. Now go to reflectance, click on layers, click add and click GGX. Then go to layer 1 and change this attenuation to additive and then change this roughness value to 0 and reflection strength make it 10% and change the brightness to 80% like this and then close. Now drag this color and drop it on your bowl. Perfect. So this looks good. Now let's play our animation. So click on this play button over here and over here we will stop somewhere in between and now we will give a color to our spheres. Now we will use a trick and make it a random color so that each of the ball have a different color. So what we will do, come over here, double click here and then go to reflectance over here, click on layers, click add and click GGX, click on layer 1 and change this attenuation to additive, change this roughness value to 0, reflection strength make it 10% and keep brightness as 100% and then go to colors, click here, then on texture click here and go to effects and select variation. Next click on this variation over here, move it upward and then scroll down like this and over here for this gradient blend increase it to 100%, change this gradient mode to replace like this and on this random color decrease this value to 0%. Next click on this arrow over here, click this one, scroll down further like this and click on load preset and here select this full colors and then close it like this. Now drag this new color and drop it on a sphere. Perfect. Now rotate it a bit, position it like this and I will do a quick render by clicking on shift plus R button and see this is how each of the sphere will look different color. Now close this window. Next zoom out a bit and then go over here and insert a sky. Now for this sky we will bring a HDRA image. So over here next to this objects click on this content browser and on this content browser you will have some folders. So click on presets and click again on presets, click on lightning and click HDRA image. Now scroll down and select this sunny promenade, drag and drop over here. Now go back and click on this objects again. Now come over here and drag this HDRA image on this sky like this. Now double click on this sunny promenade over here and uncheck the reflectance and close it. Then go to sky, right click, go to render tags and click on compositing. Click on compositing, come over here and seen by camera, uncheck. Perfect. So this looks good. Now go back to frame 0 over here. Next we will create a backdrop. Okay, so zoom out a bit, go over here and insert a plane and then go to object and change the value width to 8000 and height also to 8000 and change the orientation to minus Z. Now zoom out. Okay. And go to coordinates and change this Z value to 2000. Okay, so this looks good. Zoom in further. Next we will create a material for this backdrop. So for this backdrop material I will bring in a image. So double click over here, double click on this and go to reflectance and uncheck. Now go to color and then go to texture and load image. Now over here I have already downloaded some of the images, and you can find these images on the description section of this video. So now I will click on this wall hanging and open, say no and close this. Now drag this material and drop on this backdrop. Okay, perfect. This is how it looks like. Now come over here on this section over here and change this length U to 50% and length V to 50%, and change this offset V value to 3%. Now this is done. So backdrop is ready. So let me reposition it like this. Okay, perfect. This looks good. Next, we will create a material for this conveyor belt. So double click over here, double click, reflectance uncheck, go to color, go to texture, load image, and select this rust texture image. Again, you can find the link of this images on the description section of this video. So click on this and open, click no and then close it. Now drag this new material and drop it on this cloner and on this cube. Now come over here on this projection and change this UVW mapping to cubic. Perfect. Now zoom in. Now again double click on this material which we have just created. Go over here and reflectance check. Go to layers, click add and insert a GGX. Go to layer 1 and change this attenuation to additive. Make roughness, keep it 10%. Reflection strength, make it 10%. And brightness, make it 50%. And then close it. Next, drop the same material on this front wheel and also on this back wheel. Next, we will create a material for this floor. So double click here, double click, reflectance uncheck, go to color, go to texture, load image, select this marble. Again, you can find the link of this image on the description section of this video. Click this, open, say no and close this. Now drag this material and drop it on this floor. Now come over here, change this projection to cubic and length U change it to 400% and length V again change it to 400%. Now we will create some scene objects to make this look good. So insert a cube and go to object and change Y value to 2000. Click on this fillet, change fillet radius to 10 and fillet subdivision to 10. Now click on this coordinates and change this X value to 1700 and Y value to 500. Now come over here and rename it. Rename it to right pillar. And then click on this right pillar, Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and rename it to left pillar. Now click on this left pillar, come over here on this coordinates and change this X value to -1700 and enter. Okay, so now we have two pillars. Here is the right one and this is the left one. Now let's create a material for these pillars. So double click here, double click on this, reflectance uncheck, go to color, go to texture, load image and select this resting pillar image and say open, say no and close this. Now drag this material and drop it here. Again drag this and drop it here. Now the same material drag and drop on this cylinder. Next we will insert one more object. So click over here and insert a cylinder. Go to object and change the radius to 25 and height value to 3300 and change the orientation to minus X and go to coordinates and change this Y value to 1100. Okay, so here is our cylinder now and this is in right place. Now drag this material 3 and drop it on this rod. Okay, this looks good. Now come to this UV projection over here and change it to cubic. Okay, so this looks good now. Now let's play our animation for one more time. So come back to frame 0 and play our animation. Okay, this looks good. So stop the animation, go back to frame 0, zoom out a bit like this, move it. Now we will insert couple of lights to make this scene look good. So come over here and click on this area light. Now move this upward like this, move it towards the left like this. Now come over here on this P value and decrease the value, make it minus 90 degree like this, and then go to shadow over here and select this shadow maps soft. Then go to coordinates and change this X value to minus 800 and Y value to 1900 and Z value to minus 450. Okay, so this is our light one. Now click on this light, Control plus C and Control plus V, and on this second light move it towards the right and change this X value to plus 800. Okay, perfect. So now our scene and animation is all set. So last thing which we need to do is do a render settings. So come over here, click on this render setting button, go to effect and select global illumination, change this samples value to high, again go to effect and click on ambient occlusion, and here on this ambient occlusion change this accuracy to 100%, maximum sample to 128. Now go to output and change this preset to film video and select HGTV 1080 29.97, and on this frame range select all frames. Perfect. Now go to save and change this format to JPG. Now click on this button and select a folder, click a new folder, create render images, select it, give it a name, say one, and click save, and then close this. Now let's play our animation for the last time. This is how it will look like. You can zoom in. Okay, so stop the animation, go back to frame 0, and then click on this render button over here. Now this will start rendering our images, which you can use it for making a video. So thanks for watching this video. If you like it, give me a like, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching this video.